who said in the hands of her torturers, you can do with me what you like, I'm not going to tell you. She had harbored an Orthodox priest, and she wasn't going to, they wanted to know where he was or where he'd been, and she wasn't going to tell them. And she said to them, you can do what you like to me. But and why, how did she manage, how could she stand up to O'Brien like that? Because of her faith. Why does Winston crumple under O'Brien? Because of his, ultimately, his lack of faith. You and I, Roman Catholics, because of 250 years of young girls, young boys, old men, old women, all kinds, the martyrs of the early church. And the Roman Empire tried to come up to them and tried to crush them and tried to tell them that Rome is the truth. Rome, Rome, Rome. And they said, I'm sorry. All respect to Rome. It's our country. It's our home. But the number one is not Rome. Number one is God. What? Number one is God, and your majesty, say these virgin girls to the great emperor. You may do with me what you like, on the wheel or with fire and with sword, with rack, and rope. You do what you like, but I'm not going to change. I will not drop a grain of incense, burn a grain of incense to the worship of Rome or the worship of the Roman emperor. I worship the true God. And the poor girl is the lucky girl. Is then tortured to death, and she goes straight to heaven. It's going to take, my dear friends, another generation of martyrs and another flowing of blood, another enormous flowing of blood, to rescue the church. To rescue the church. I didn't say save. The church doesn't need to be saved, but it does need to be rescued. And therefore, be prepared, my dear friends, for the advance of globalism, for the advance of apparent total power of the enemies of God, and when that happens, strengthen your faith. Ask God to strengthen your faith so that you and I will not crumple in the hands of today's O'Briens. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Amen.